Can you hear this? Can you hear the chainsaw man? It was much louder than that, like, a minute ago. It's been going on for like 15 minutes. Who needs to chainsaw that long? I swear I am this close to selling this. I don't know if I said last night, I can't remember, as I have mentioned many times, probably. I don't remember, my memory is terrible. Sorry, I'm just getting tired already. I played this on my phone for an hour and a half, fair enough, and then I lost it again, fair enough. So I thought, okay, I actually have the cartridge, I'll go and play it, it's fine, it'll be okay. And then I remembered why I didn't do it. I don't know how to delete. So I thought, okay, just click new game, that'll be grand. Got 2.5 hours in, beat the first gym, got my starter Pokemon evolved, you know, did a bunch of little mini quests, like, you know, oh, this person wants to trade a Bellsprout for an Onix or something like that. Did all those things and then went to save it so I could actually go to bed, and no, you can't save it here, you already have saved. I really hate Pokemon doing the one save thing. Like, I know why they do it, because the world is so big and there's so much data to save, but like, still, could you not? In total, I think I've wasted, so we'll say 8 hours for playing on the phone, which I lost, and then another 2.5 hours. I've wasted 10.5 hours playing Pokemon, and it's all gone this week. Like, what else could I have done in that 10 hours? I could finish my game. Could have done God only knows what else. But I'm so annoyed. This cartridge is cursed. Tiny quick update. My other stuff arrived. Thank you. I think that says Jake. Thank you, Jake, for packing my stuff. I'm gonna go and find something sharp to open this and have a sniff. Oh, and apparently it was also made by Itzy. Thank you both. Oh, I can smell it through the packet. It smells really good. I only got two things. I would have thought, you know, Redbubble style can go through the letterbox box would have done better, but what do I know? I'm not going to do like a review thing like I planned. I want to grab all of my Lush stuff that I still have and like put it into a big pile and get the big camera, the bridge camera, whatever it's called, and do like a proper video on stuff about Lush and my favourites. So I'm not going to do that here. I'm just going to cut this open and have a sniff like a weirdo. Are Lush like not meant to be all about, you know, reducing packaging and shit? Like, there's two shampoo bars in here. Look at the amount of packing peanuts and this massive thing of paper, just to say what my, sorry, I'm covering up my address, covering what shampoo I got. Like, if there was a free gift or some shit in here, I'd be okay about it, but there isn't. There's literally just, like, you can see the shampoo bar. It's not even, like, specially packaged or anything. Just free-floating. It smells really good, though. It's not quite coffee. It's very sweet. And also very dusty and dry. That feels gross. But it smells good. Trying to find the other one. The other one in here is called Lullaby, I think. Oh, it's much pinker than I thought it would be. I thought it was going to be like a, I don't know, like a millennial pink, I believe is the name of the colour. Oh, it smells so lavendery. It's amazing. I'll definitely be using that one. Yeah, but seriously, what about all the packing peanuts? Like, I know these things are water soluble and all that. Like, I don't know, are they biodegradable as well? Can you filter them out? Who knows? It just seems a bit unnecessary to me. But again, I'm not Lush, so what do I know? Remember, we're parked beside the 60p hot dogs. Oh, got a block jack. Put the bread down, Jack. I really like this little apartment house thing, whatever it's got going on. It's very light. You're about to walk in again. This one too. It's fancy. Look at the floor. It's amazing. If I ever get a house of my own, this is how I'd like it decorated. This one or the black one. I love this big mirror thing. And the red lights. I imagine it'll be kind of hard to see bugs though. Tiny chairs. They're so small.
Yeah, good point, because you'd have to give them an idea of what size they are.
I see. You know all about this, do you? Are there more? No. Oh, what a shame. I mean, I would never use them for coat hooks, but they're cute.
The unintended consequence of coming to IKEA, Jack is now discussing moving out of the house and is absolutely livid about the idea of me getting his bedroom. I don't think Mum's terribly happy either. She's a bit upset at the thought of him moving out. That's nice. What I'd really like to do is, I have quite a, you know, fairly sized room, but I would like a bigger room, and I would certainly like a bigger bed, because my bed's very childish and I've had it since I was in first year. So it's 11 years. I mean, it's been moved across the house, but it's just, it's not as nice as it could be. And I would like a different one, and I would certainly like it bigger, obviously, because I'm an adult now and I'd like some space. So we'll see. See if I can convince her. Tell me this lamp doesn't look like boobs with tiny nipples. Tell me it doesn't. Please. Who was consulted on this? I bet no one. I want one of these guys so much. Look at their little teeth and their faces. They're so soft. They're amazing, but Mum won't let me. I'll be back for you.
What the what? I'm awake again. I went for a nap because after I got home from IKEA I had a really bad headache. I'm so sad when Jack wouldn't let me get that shark. It was amazing! And like, when's the last time you saw a teddy bear that big for 15 quid? Alright, you go to like, I don't know, the Disney store and there's like this teeny weeny Mickey Mouse and he's like, I don't know, 20 bucks and then the big ones are like 40. And you go to like a Build-A-Bear workshop, which I have been in recently. And those teddy bears are really expensive and just, I want that shark. I'm gonna find a way to get that shark. I know I said I was gonna be sensible with my money, but the shark is a good investment. And I'm still being sensible with my money if I save up for it. I'm such an apologist. I suppose if my mom and Jack had let me get that, they would have been enablers to a terrible habit. I went from really sad at the start of this video to laughing. I did get one thing today. I didn't get anything in IKEA, which I was a bit upset about. I forgot to measure to get my shelves. So I have no idea what the gap is, but the size the gap is to, you know, get them. And they don't do cut to measure shelves, which is annoying. You have to just like find ones that fit best. Didn't get any tiny pots for my candle making and soap making either. I'm gonna maybe just look online because I'm sure they're probably cheaper. I did get this. It was like 33 quid and it was a pound cheaper online and would have had to wait for it for a couple of days. I just decided to go and get it from Argos because I'm consumerist garbage. Haven't started it yet. Not going to. I'm gonna finish whatever it was I was doing a minute ago. Okay, maybe not because I don't remember. Gonna do some of my game tonight. Fingers crossed. Probably not gonna make another video tonight. Maybe. I don't know. We'll see. I always say that and then I do wind up making another video, but considering how long it took me to render and do the other one yesterday. Or wasn't even yesterday, it was this morning at like midnight. It took me too long to do it. It was 17 minutes long of me just talking shite. So I've decided to cut them down, like really cut them down, and try and render them more quickly. Because it's taken too long. It was, and plus no one watches them, and I don't need to record so much to remember so much of the day. It's supposed to be like highlights and shit. Alright, I'm gonna go again because I'm rambling now, so I will maybe see you tomorrow. I don't know what we're doing. But I'll try and bring my camera with me anyway. Bye!
I should try to vlog quite quickly before all the lights go out again. There's a massive crazy storm coming in. I didn't think it was going to be this bad, but... Can you hear the wind? It's making the conservatory crack.